When I was in my freshman year of high school, I liked this one girl who was kind, she was smart, she was funny, had a great sense of humor, and I developed feelings for her during the school year. My school, they put on a dance, and my friend told me about it. He was like, "Hey, are you gonna go with anyone?" And I thought about it, and I was like, "You know what, maybe I'll ask my crush out." And my friend was like, "Ooh, asking out your crush? You making moves?" And I just kind of laughed it off when I said, "You know what? Yeah, I'm gonna make my move, you know? It's like now or never." And my friend was like, "Yeah, okay, I see you. Go get her." And I was like, "Thanks, yo." Before the dance, I had bought 2 tickets, one for me, one for her. I had to choose between 2 ways to ask her out. Now, the first way I could have done it was I could have done it casually, but I don't want to do it casually. I want to go up and say, "Hey, want to go to the dance with me? What's the fun in that?" So I decided, you know what? I'm going to make this elaborate. So what I did is that my school offers singing telegrams. And what they do is that, like, you choose a song. I chose the "You and Me" song by The Wannadies. I paid them $10, went all out, added, you know, like, give her this, like, you know, give her these chocolates, give her some candy. Second period is when they send the telegram. And second period comes, I'm just thinking, like, you know what, they're sending this telegram out right now. But I felt confident in myself saying, you know what, she's going to be so touched by this, she's going to be so flattered, she's going to have to say yes. And I was like, yeah, mission accomplished. That is until lunch came around. One of my friends told me, "Hey, this girl was looking for you." I was like, "Okay, man, tell her where I'm at." And then she finds me with her group of people. She has a huge group of friends. There's like 15 people in her girl group. And she looks me dead in the eye, everyone watching us. So there was like 200 kids looking at us. And she says, "I appreciate that you sent me that message, but I don't want to go to the dance with you. I'm sorry." My friends, they were just like, you know, roasting on me. They were like, "Oh man, he got denied. He got rejected, friend zoned." I try to act cool and poised, and I just walked out. When I got home, I was an emotional wreck. I was in tears. I was angry. I was upset. But you have to think about this. No, this isn't going to be the first heartbreak I'm going to go through in my life. You got to go through some heartbreaks to actually find someone who's actually interested in you, for you. And I go back to school. The people who were roasting on me actually gave me some respect. They were like, "You know what? What you did was above and beyond. We wouldn't do anything like that." And I didn't go to the dance. I just gave the tickets away to a friend of mine who already had a date. So yeah, that was like the most embarrassing thing that's happened to me up to this point in my life.
Oh my god, and we totally jumped off the cliff and had to swim all the way to shore because the dog chased us all the way to the end. Oh.